Last night at 8:18 p.m., State Patrol troopers, along with Sleepy Eye Police and Brown County Sheriff's Department, responded to a two-vehicle crash on Highway 14 just west of Sleepy Eye. When troopers, officers, and deputies arrived, they found a crash involved a Pontiac Grand Prix and a Dodge pickup. The preliminary information based on the investigation thus far indicates the Grand Prix was westbound on Highway 14. And just for reference, on the screen over here to the left, the curve we're referring to, I'll just point it out to you, is right here. This is Sleepy Eye, and this is the curve that the crash occurred in. There's a set of S-curves to the west of Sleepy Eye and Highway 14. This is where Highway 14 curves from the west to the south, is where the crash occurred. But the Pontiac Grand Prix, which was traveling westbound entering the curve, lost control, went into the eastbound lanes where a Dodge pickup was traveling in the opposite direction. The pickup struck the Pontiac Grand Prix in the driver, or I'm sorry, in the passenger side, broadside. As a result, there were five occupants in the Grand Prix. The vehicle was driven by Kansas Adams. First name is Kansas, same as the state. Adams, common spelling, age 19 of Sleepy Eye, Minnesota. He suffered serious injuries. The four passengers in that vehicle all died as a result of the injuries they sustained. They were identified as Peyton Adams, age 17 of Sleepy Eye, who is believed to be the brother of the driver of Kansas. Caleb Quisenberry, age 17 of St. Peter. John Mangan, age 18 of Fairfax, and Tyler Hadley, age 20 of Sleepy Eye. All their names, spellings, and information are posted on the State Patrol website at this time. The driver of the other vehicle was identified as Douglas Wyborg, age 43 of New Ulm. Also in his vehicle were two children, his children, Jacob Wyborg, age 9, and Sydney Wyborg, age 7. Douglas, all three occupants sustained non-life-threatening injuries. Douglas was taken to the Sleepy Eye Hospital, and Jacob and Sydney were transported to Children's Hospital in Minneapolis, again with non-life-threatening injuries. Also, preliminary information indicates the road was icy at the time. There was some weather in that part of the state yesterday, which led to some icy roadways and snowy and icy roadways. Also, it should be noted that of the five passengers in the Grand Prix, the only one that we have confirmed was wearing a seatbelt as the surviving driver. It's unknown on the initial information. It was unclear if the front seat passengers was wearing a seatbelt, but none of the rear seat passengers were wearing a seatbelt. In the pickup truck, both the driver, Mr. Wyborg, and his two children were all wearing seatbelts at the time of the crash. Any questions? At this time, there was no indication of alcohol on Mr. Wyborg. Regarding Kansas Adams or any of the passengers, it's unknown at this time. There was a substance believed to be marijuana located in the Pontiac Grand Prix. However, what, if any, role that may or may have played in this crash is yet to be determined.